Hello friends and welcome back. In this lecture, we will talk about the scanner class in Java. Here's our outline. First of all, we will talk about the scanner class. Then we will instantiate a scanner object, or we will create a variable of type scanner, alright? And after that, we will have a look at input methods. And finally, we will see some examples on reading input from the keyboard. So let's get started. Suppose that we have a program that prints hello to the username. For example, have a look over here. I have a string which is called username and it is equal to this string over here. And I'm using the println method to say hello to the username, alright? So as you can see over here, we are storing a value inside the variable username. So suppose that we want the user to enter his name using the keyboard and then we want to print hello username. So this is where we will use the scanner class. It allows us to read input from the keyboard. So for example, we will be able to tell the user to enter his name, and after that we can store the name inside a variable, for example, or we can print it, alright? So because we need to use the scanner class, we have to instantiate a scanner object. So we are going to create a variable of type scanner, okay? So we will have something like this. We are using the name of the class, which is scanner, and we are calling the variable, for example, input. This can be anything, alright? And you are assigning this variable to be equal to a new scanner, okay? So this is the constructor of the scanner class. And in here, we are giving system.n as a parameter. So we are creating an object that reads data from system.n. Now, system.n points to the keyboard. You already know system.out, which points to the screen. We also have system.in, which points to the keyboard, all right? So now this object can be used in order to read data from the keyboard. So let me show you more about this system.in. First of all, it is a field of the system class. And it is also a static field because we are accessing it using the name of the class, right? And the type of this field is input stream. So this is an object of the input stream class. So as I said, now our input object can be used to read data from the keyboard. And to read data, we are going to use input methods, which are methods that are used to read specific types of data from the keyboard. So for example, have a look over here. I'm using our scanner object and I'm accessing the methods using the dot operator. And as you can see, I'm calling a method that is called next. And this method takes no parameters. We use this method in order to read a string from the keyboard. Another example, we have a method that is called nextInt. This reads an integer from the keyboard. We also have nextDouble, which reads a double, alright? And have a look over here. We have nextByte, nextShort, nextLong, nextFloat, and nextBoolean. So, when we call one of these methods, the program will pause execution and wait for the user to enter a value. And after that, the entered value will be returned by these methods, alright? And note that we don't have nextChar. And later on, we will see how we can read a character from the keyboard, alright? Don't worry about it. Now, let's make everything clear by seeing some examples. We are going to read input from the keyboard. Have a look at this code over here. I'm creating our scanner object and I'm calling it input. Then I'm using the println method and I'm printing input.next. So what do you think will happen over here? First of all, the println method will see that we are printing input.next. So the next method will be called. So as we said, our program will pause execution and it will wait for the user to enter some data. So have a look over here. The program will pause execution over here and it will wait for us to enter some value. So as you can see, this green string was written by me. And this is the input that we are giving to our program. After we press enter, this string will be returned by the next function. So it will be returned to the println function. And as you can see, our string is printed. Alright? Let's see another example. Have a look over here. We are creating our input object. And first of all, I'm printing using the print method, enter your name. And I'm leaving a space. And after that, I'm printing your name is. And then I'm concatenating the result that will be returned by the next method. So when we run our program, this string will be printed. And after that, we are going to print this string, right? And as you can see, we are calling the next method. So our program will pause execution and wait for us to enter some value. So have a look over here. We can see enter your name. And because we are using the print method, whenever I type my name, it is still on the same line. After I press enter, we can see your name is and my string printed. So this is our input and it was returned by the next method. And after that, it is concatenated to this string over here. And this is why we see this output over here, alright? Now let's see another example. We still have the same code from before, but when we run our program, I will enter my full name. So now I have a space over here. So when we press enter, we will only see the first word printed. So the next method only reads up until the first space. So this string over here was not read. We only read the first word, right? So let's see how we can read a full sentence even with spaces. Have a look over here. We have the same code, but now I'm using the next line method. And this method reads a sentence even with spaces. It does not stop at spaces. So now if we run our program and we put a sentence even with spaces, we can see our input printed, alright? So these are the basics, and you can use other methods in the same way. So you can read an integer, a double, and anything you want using the methods that we saw before, alright? So now I want you to practice. I want you to read an integer, a double, a float, and a boolean, and anything that you want. After that, store the values inside variables. And remember, the type of the variable should be compatible with the input that we are reading from the keyboard, right? After that, print the values. And also, try to perform some arithmetic. So read some integers and do some arithmetic operations with the values, alright? And finally, see what errors you might get. So this is it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.